Hello and welcome to the series of Shades of Pregnancy. This is Dr. Trupti, and today on this platform of Trupt Wellness, we are going to discuss the most wide topic in pregnancy, that is diet. Now, why diet is so important during pregnancy? So first of all, this is the only way through which we can send nutrients and nourish our baby. According to neuroscience, the origin of adult disease has its roots in the fetal life itself. So maternal nutrition plays very important role in the coming baby's future health conditions. Also, Ayurveda says, Striya yapanya garbhaya tridha rasah pratipadyate sva sharira pushtaye stanyaya garbha vruddhaye cha. So here Acharya Charaka says, pregnant woman needs to fulfill three responsibilities, and those are: first one is sva sharir pushti, that is nourishment of her own body first. Second is stanya vruddhi, that is preparing herself for lactation or milk production. And the third and most important is garbha vruddhi, that is nourishment for development and growth of fetus. Various nutritive substances, hormones, electrolytes essential for the development of fetus diffuses directly from mother's blood into fetal blood through placenta. And if the mother's diet is not properly balanced or inadequate, then the baby may suffer due to lack of essential nutrients, which directly affects on the fetal development like liver, spleen, kidney, etc. Now listen this carefully, it's very important. The quality of nutrition that goes in your baby's system lays the foundation of your child health for entire lifetime. Disorders like diabetes, hypertension, heart diseases, mental disorders has its roots in the womb. So now you can imagine the importance of diet. As we have seen the irritation levels in first trimester due to different type of complaints, so eating already is a big difficulty. In this episode, Eat Small, Eat More, this principle will help you to sustain through these early days of pregnancy. Now let's see modern statistics regarding diet in first trimester. Average weight gain of a woman during whole pregnancy should be up to 12 kg in normal circumstances, which contributes of fetal weight up to 3.5 kg, amniotic fluid up to 2 kg, placenta up to 1.5 kg and mother's weight up to 5 kg. We are talking about normal circumstances. This may differ in different women according to their weights. So, our diet should be filled with all essential macro and micronutrients in order to gain the above things. Macronutrients are the ones which are needed in large amount and provides energy. We all know there are three macronutrients: carbohydrates, proteins and fats. And micronutrients are needed in very small quantity, but they are essential for normal physiological functions, and those are vitamins and minerals. Now let's see the important micronutrients in first trimester. The first comes iron. As we all know, blood volume in pregnancy increases, so the need of iron also increases. Then come vitamin C. This is very important for absorption of iron. Then comes zinc. This is important for your baby's immunity. Then comes magnesium. This maintains the blood pressure of mother to avoid the conditions like eclampsia and preeclampsia in later stages of pregnancy. Then comes omega-3. This is very important for the brain development of your baby. Now let's see the whole day meal plan according to our nutrients need and also Ayurvedic science on first trimester. The first meal of the day, it should be taken near about 7 to 7:30 a.m. in morning. According to Ayurveda, Panchamrit is the best option for this time. It can be easily prepared at home. You can take 5 teaspoons of milk, 2 teaspoons of ghee, 1 teaspoon of sugar, 1 teaspoon of honey and 1 teaspoon of curd. Mix all these things properly and you can have it in early morning. This will give you the energy in those fatigue days and also it will nourish your body. Next option is fruits. The alkaline quality of fruits will help to reduce your acidity as well as morning sickness. Fruits like apple, pomegranate, fresh figs, watermelon contains iron, which is the need of first trimester. Also, banana contains lot of potassium, which will help to maintain the balance between fluids and electrolytes in vomiting. One more good option for this time is dry fruits and nuts. Eat soaked dry fruits like figs, dates, raisins, almonds, walnut, which contains magnesium and iron, and which also helps in the baby's brain development. Second meal of the day, breakfast. One of the very important meals in whole day. This should be done near about 8 to 9 a.m. in morning. Compulsory include one milk product like curd, butter, paneer or a glass of milk, as the demand of protein is high in these days. Breakfast options like poha, upma, dalia are very good as it contains carbohydrates which will provide you energy in those fatigued days due to vomitings. One whose appetite is good and don't have any complaints can also have stuffed rotis like parathas, multigrain vegetable sandwiches, moong chila, etc. Sprouts, either roasted in ghee or cooked, are one of the best option for breakfast as they are rich source of proteins. If you are feeling more acidic or nauseous, then you can just have a roasted bread and butter or jawar flakes. The third meal of the day, mid-morning meals. It should be done near about 10 to 11 a.m. Here you can take local drinks like kokum sherbet, lemon sherbet, coconut water, buttermilk, etc., which will help in your rehydration due to vomitings, and also they will help to reduce your acidity. Lemon and kokum contains vitamin C, which will help in iron absorption, and also they act as very good antacids. You can just add a pinch of salt, sugar, pepper or cumin powder, which will help in your digestion too. Buttermilk contains vitamin B12, which will again help in your iron absorption, and also it will help to reduce your bloating and acidity. Coconut water will help to maintain the balance between fluid and electrolytes due to dehydration in vomitings, and also it will help to maintain amniotic fluid levels in later months of pregnancy. The fourth meal of the day, lunch. It should be done near about 12 to 1 in afternoon. Along with a normal vegetable, try to include one green leafy vegetable like spinach, fenugreek, etc. according to availability in your region in your lunch. Compulsory add one bowl of dal to your meals, as proteins are very much essential in these days. You can have split dals like red gram or green gram, which are easy to digest in first trimester. You can also add drumstick and spinach, which are rich in calcium, and they will also help to maintain your hemoglobin levels. You can have jawar roti or wheat roti, or also a multigrain roti according to availability of your region. You can have ghee rice or curd rice. Curd contains very essential amino acids and also vitamin B12, which will help to reduce your cravings and also reduce acidity. Don't forget to add the fresh salad like cucumber, onion, tomato, carrot, etc., or a preparation called raita. Now let's see Ayurvedic aspect. Garbhastu khalu antariksha vaivagni toya bhumi vikara chetana adhishthana bhutah, which means we all are made up of five elements called as Panchamahabhutas, and those are: Antariksha is space, Agni is fire, Vayu is air, Toya is water, Prithvi is earth, along with Chetana, that is soul. Each of this element has specific role in growth of fetus. So, maintaining equilibrium of all these Mahabhutas through diet is very important in pregnancy. We must eat in tune with these five elements, especially when nurturing a life within. Now, let's see how to tune with these elements. The first one, space. Take time to hear your inner signals while eating. Sit in a calm and proper place to eat. Slow down your pace, find your space and eat. Assign your meals properly with regular time intervals. The next element, air. Don't rush on your meals and overeat. Eat your meals to a point of feeling light. Serve yourself smaller portions at one time. Eat light food which is easy to digest. The third element, fire. Eat cooked food which is said to be purified by Agni, that is fire. Freshly cooked food means within 2 to 3 hours of cooking. No reheating of food in microwaves. Avoid packet foods. The fourth element, water. As we know, dehydration is the major issue due to vomitings in first trimester. So keep the hydrating element alive in your food. Stale food is drier than fresh food as it lacks hydrating element. So try to eat fresh food and fruits. Also take local drinks like coconut water, sherbets, porridges, etc. The last element, earth. Sit down close to earth while eating. Eat all fruits and vegetables from your land which are cultivated in the region you are living. Also try to eat seasonal stuff which will make you more stronger to carry your pregnancy in easier way. We will discuss about remaining details in next episode. Till then, stay happy, stay blessed. Thank you. Hey guys, thanks for watching my video. If you like our content, then please like, share and subscribe our channel. You can also follow us on Instagram and Facebook. Don't forget to share this video with the expectant couples in your family and friends. Thank you.